So my title of my speech is controlling the degree of hydrophilicity and hydrophobicity of semiconductor surfaces via porosification and metal depositions. So the outline is a little bit of motivation, wetting properties of bulk gallium arsenide surface decorated by gold thin films and nanodots, some technological approaches, wetting properties of porous gallium arsenide with different crystallographic orientation, some preliminary results of indium phosphide, and conclusion. So nowadays, a lot of researchers focus on control the wettability of the surface because there is a lot of application like anti-corrosions, anti-icing, and microfluidics, and so on. Today, the plenary session, we have seen that Professor Tiginiano introduced it on aerogallnet, which exhibit dual properties at the same time, so hydrophilic and hydrophobic properties, and it's a very interesting application of these materials. I will start to present some results on porous indium gallium phosphide at the beginning. So on the left side of the screen, we can see a photo of gallium arsenide crystal after deposition of gold nanodots via pulsed electrochemical deposition. So pulsed electrochemical deposition is very cost-effective technology. That means that the electrodeposition is performed at room temperature. So a little amount of electrolyte is used and also a very low-cost equipment is used also. We can see that the contact angle for bulk gallium arsenide, so without gold nanodots, it's about 80 degrees. After deposition at different parameters of electrochemical deposition, I mean that the thickness, so the length of the pulse can be changed. In our case, we used 50 microseconds and 300 microseconds. And as we can see from the SEM images, the deposition at 50 microseconds leads to the formation of gold film composite from so compactly arranged nanodots, about 20 nanometers in diameter. It's one monolayer of nanodots. So it's a lot of surface is covered with thin layer of this nanodots. While at longer pulse duration of deposition, we can see that the deposited nanofilm of gold is perforated. It can be easily explained that at longer pulse duration leads to the formation of bulbs at the surface, and where a bulb is formed, no electrochemical deposition occurs. After measurements of contact angle, we can see that the, we can switch the property of the surface down, so it's more hydrophilic surface. And while at the pulse duration about 300 microseconds leads to the decrease, it's very impressive decrease, it's about 40 grad, the contact angle. So it's a very simple technique to change the hydrophilicity of the surface. Now to compare how the morphology of the film, gold film, about wetting properties, we compared with samples covered with gold thin films by sputtering. It was used the Cresentong sputter systems, and thin films with thickness about 7 nanometers till 25 nanometers were deposited. And we can see that in this case, the deposition of thin films leads to the decrease, but not so much of the contact angles. This can be explained very simply, and we can see in this graph. For example, bulk gallium arsenide, so without deposition, when we measure the current IV characteristic, so we can see that in the process is it's a lot of current, it's implied a lot of current. So this bulk material is not covered with gold. When we deposit gold by sputtering, we can the red line, we can see that practically no current until 5 volts appears at the surface of the semiconductor crystals. While when the surface is covered with pulsed electrochemical deposition, we can see the increase of the current, and much current is reached at 300 microseconds, because from the SEM images, we can see that the, this deposited film is perforated. So it's a porous gold films. While at lower pulse duration, we have more compact deposition of the dots and much less electrolyte participate in the dissociation of the semiconductors and the electrolyte. So it's a demonstration that pulse electrochemical deposition can adjust the surface wetting properties of the surface. For example, it's a two-step technological approach. So at the beginning, at the first step, on the bulk semiconductor substrate is deposited thin films by electrochemical pulsed electrochemical deposition. So we can see the mechanism. So we name it the Hopping electrode deposition of gold, because at the nucleation, some dots appears on the surface. After that, they reach a critical threshold value about 20 nanometers in diameter, and the another dots nucleate on the surface. And this mechanism continue until the all surface is covered with one monolayer of gold nanodot. After that, the gold starts to deposit on gold, and it's a not Schottky barrier, it's a ohmic contact, gold, and the deposition is not so uniformly. So we use just first step of the Hopping electrochemical deposition to obtain a monolayer of nanodot. So after that, in the second step, we can electrochemical etch this surface at low voltage and a little bit higher voltage, for example, 3 volts and 4 volts. And in this case, anodization at low voltage leads to the formation of the porous layer underneath the gold layer. So we can see in the insert the formation of the porous gallium arsenide, and on the top we have a gold layer, a perforated layer. While anodization at high anodization potential leads to the detachment of the this gold layer, and it is possible to obtain the perforated nanomembranes. And in the second step, also it's possible to obtain the porous semiconductor with nanodots without membrane. In this image, we can see one sample with three different regions. So from the right, it's a bulk region, so initial surface, porous, and porous covered with thin layer of gold nanodots. Thin layer is it's about 25 and up to 50 nanometers in thickness. So bulk surface, the contact angle is about 80 degree. And while porous materials, so exhibit very hydrophilic properties, and the contact angle decrease very sharply. We can see the morphology of the porous gallium arsenide. It's a highly porous materials. So while when we cover the porous layer with a thin layer of gold nanodots, we can increase the contact angle. So it's a more hydrophobic. In this case, we on the same sample in different regions, we have hydrophilic and hydrophobic properties of the materials. It's another example, the anodization of 111-oriented gallium arsenide. In the previously case was 100. When we use 111 crystallographic orientation, we can etch semiconductor crystal from two sides. So we have two surface 111A and 111B. So the anodization on different surface leads to the different orientation of the pores. So here we can see the pores penetrating each other, so they are tilted about 55 degrees to the semiconductor surface. And in the case on 111B surface, it is possible to obtain pores perpendicular to the semiconductor surface, or even nanowires, like in this case. So we can see that different morphology also have a very high influence about wettability of the surface. And we can see that the porous morphology, like in case A, we have a very hydrophobic surface. And in the case of the nanowires oriented perpendicular, the surface is hydrophilic. So the changing of the wettability of the surface is possible just via porosification, so without gold deposition. Another example is porous indium phosphide. This work also not just for gallium phosphide, but also for indium phosphide. In the right, we have a bulk indium phosphide with dots. And the contact angle is about 95 grad. And here we can see a piece of bulk materials, and in the middle we have a porous region and a drop of water exhibiting about contact angle about 150 degrees. So it's closer to the hydrophobicity. It's a very high contact angle, and it's also just for so via nanostructuring of the semiconductor bulk material. In conclusion, I want to mention that wetting properties of gallium arsenide surface can be engineered by electrochemical deposition of gold nanodots, and also to increase the hydrophilicity was demonstrated for deposition of gold with longer pulse duration, so which led to the formation of perforated gold membranes on the surface of gallium arsenide. And the introduced porosity of the semiconductor surface gives the possibility to control the wetting property of gallium arsenide surface, while the tilted or perpendicular pores to the surface also play an important role in the switching from hydrophobic to hydrophilic properties. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you for your talk. And please, questions?
I have a question. How you choose the pulse duration?
The pulse duration, we have a pulse generator, and the pulse duration is so adjusted experimentally at the beginning. So on the bulk surface, the pulse duration is not so important. The most important is when we speak or want to introduce some nanodots inside of the porous materials. So the pulse duration play a very important role. For example, at the beginning, the electrolyte penetrates in the pores, inside the pores. And if you apply a very long pulse duration, all ions from the electrolytes are deposited on the wall or the surface. We have to choose the optimal pulse duration and the it's a more important pulse between the duration between the pulses, so the repulse, to avoid to give the possibility to refresh the electrolyte inside the pores or on the surface. On the bulk materials, it's not so important because we have a steering of the electrolyte. And the electrolyte is very easily refreshed at the interface between semiconductors and the electrode. So the most important is just for porous materials when we want to deposit, for example, nanotubes or nanowires inside porous material.
Thank you.
Thank you.